Hello everyone and welcome to Roadmap. So we are continuing with the topic light part 2, and if you like the video, don't forget to click on thumbs up button below. You can also share and also you can subscribe for more video updates, and you can also give your suggestions in the comment section below. So the topics to be covered are introduction, rectilinear propagation of light, reflection of light, laws of reflection, real and virtual images, mirrors, difference between concave plane and convex mirror, lenses, Newton's color disk. Okay, so coming to the introduction part, I would suggest that already I have made part 1, and you just check the video, go back, so that you will have a better conceptual understanding. For now to have continuity, I'll just give a glimpse of it. That bulb gives invisible energy, which is called as light. Light travels in straight line, called rectilinear propagation of light. And the return of ray of light from the second to first optical medium with change in angle is called as reflection of light. The ray may pass through second optical medium with change in angle, and this is called as refraction of light. Optical medium, for your information, I just wrote the definition that optical medium is a material through which electromagnetic waves propagate. So already we have learned with laws of reflection and difference between real and virtual images, and then what is light in detail, and also the rectilinear examples and many things. So I would suggest to go back and check the video and then come over here. Now coming to the plane mirror, the laterally inverted image which is formed by a plane mirror. Like, stand in front of a mirror and see your own image in the mirror. Stretch out your right hand. Which hand does your image stretch? You will find that the left hand is stretched. In other words, that the left hand of the object becomes the right side of the image and vice versa. And the phenomenon of left appearing right and right appearing left on reflection in a plane mirror is called as lateral version. So you might have noticed that in front of an ambulance, the word is written like ambulance. But if you look at the driver's side, you will be able to see that it will be in the opposite way. So that means it will be in the inversion. It will have an inversion. So coming to the spherical mirrors, the plane mirrors basically are flat surface that produces erect virtual image of real object. Coming to the spherical mirrors, a spherical mirror is so called because it is considered to be a part of the sphere. And there are two types of spherical mirrors, that are concave mirror and convex mirror. In concave mirror, its outer surface is polished, and in case of convex, its inner surface is polished. And a spherical mirror is presented by drawing its section. The center is called as pole, and its center of curvature is the center of sphere of which the mirror is part. The focal point F is the point where parallel light rays are focused, and it is located half the distance from the mirror to the center of curvature. Now coming to the concave mirror. Now what I have done is that I have listed the points, but you can use it for the difference between concave mirror and convex mirror and plane mirror. So basically, concave mirror, its reflecting surface is curved inwards, and its image is formed real inverted except when the object is closer to mirror. Image is either enlarged or diminished. Now in convex mirror, the surface curved is outwards, reflecting surface, and the image formed is virtual and upright, and also the image formed is diminished. Now the meaning of diminished is smaller. Coming to the plane mirror, the reflecting surface is flat and the image formed is virtual and upright. images of same size as that of object. Now coming to the uses of mirror. Now there are many uses of mirror. I have listed some of them. It is used as a shaving mirror and in makeup mirror. It is because when the face of a person is placed between pole and focus of the concave mirror, an erect virtual and highly magnified image is formed. And it is also used as a reflector in projectors, lighthouses, car headlights, torches. This is because when the source is placed at the focus of the concave mirror, a parallel beam of light is produced. It is also used as a doctor's head mirror. So when you have sometimes you have visited to doctor, you must have seen that he checks with his head mirror. And it is to focus a parallel beam of light on the internal body part such as throat, ear, nose, teeth. And it is used to collect heat radiations in solar cooker. It is also used in flood lights. Now when the source of light is placed between pole and focus, a divergent beam is produced after reflection. Now coming to the convex mirror uses. It is used as a rear view mirror in vehicles because it forms an erect and highly diminished image, and it is irrespective of the position of the traffic behind. So it is used to view a larger area. It is also used as a reflector in street lamps as it diverges the light rays over a wide area. And it is also used as vigilance mirrors in departmental stores and big shops as anti-shoplifting devices. So I hope you are enjoying the video. Stay tuned for more lessons to come. We'll continue with the part 3. And thank you for watching.